Hey folks, this is Shomasri Chatterjee back in the Bong Bum's kitchen. As we spent the time from the last time we met till now, we celebrated Holi, the festival of colors. To all of you, my friends who are watching me on this show, I wish you all the colors of life. I wish you the passion of red mixed with the prosperity of verdant green. The calmness of cool blue, may all of this mix to make it a pristine white, as peaceful as white. Just a few words that came to my mind while we were thinking of Holi. Tumko rang lagana hai, Holi aaj manana hai. Pratikar karo, inkar karo, par rango ko swikar karo. Rango se tumhe lehlana hai, होली आज मनाना है. भर पिचकारी बौछार जो मारी, भीगी चुनरी भीगी सारी, अपने ही रंग में रंगवाना है. होली आज मनाना है, आबिद गुलाल तो बस बहाना है, तो तूरिया दिल की मिटाना है, तो कैसे ये शर्माना, होली आज मनाना है. द एसेंस ऑफ होली इज नॉट अबाउट द कलर्स, बट इट इज अबाउट mixing, intermixing of lives, of all joy, just as the colors intermix and create its own vibhjor. And what better way to make something colorful than food? And so we are back in the Bong Bum's kitchen with our own holi of spices, of tastes, and fun galore. And in today's edition, I've got another quintessential Bong Bum with me today coming in as my guest. And I'm told she's going to be making something that is very, very typical of Bengal, the east side of Bengal. And as I must have told you all, friends, that one of the essential products of ingredients, spices that make up life in Bengal is posto, that is poppy seed paste. The other is mustard, and I'm told my guest is going to be dabbling in mustard today. So let's not waste time and call in to today's guest today. Today's guest is Champa Gupta. Champa di, please welcome. How are you? This is Champa Gupta. Champa di is a typical Bong Bum, quintessential housewife. She loves singing.
Yes.
She loves singing. She has a son. He's in US right now, right?
He's doing his postdoctoral studies
in what?
If I say Arizona State University.
No, in what subject?
Chemistry.
Oh, he's a chemist. So he's doing that. And today you are cooking some fish for me, right?
Fish, katla fish with raw mango.
Raw mango. And mustard, right?
Mm.
Okay, and this is from the East Bengal side of the divide, right?
Yes.
Okay, so what are we? I see I've got katla fish here.
Katla fish fried.
I think you've already shallow fried it, right?
Shallow fried.
Okay, then we've got green chili.
Green chilies. Green mango paste.
This is green mango paste. Okay.
Sugar. Mustard paste.
Methi.
That's fenugreek.
Yeah. Whole fenugreek. You need salt.
Salt.
Haldi, turmeric.
Turmeric and
sugar. Okay, so you've got the other condiments, but you're not going to be using it. Okay, and what oil are you going to use? Mustard oil?
Yes.
The typical mustard oil. Because a lot of people are getting health conscious and are not into mustard oil, but Champa they will use. So let's start. Let's not waste time. So here we go. And here we go. Boom. Here's your pan, and here's your oil. Tell me when it's enough.
Okay.
Enough? Okay. So I heard you sing.
I learned singing Rabindra Sangeet.
Another person who's in love with Rabindra Sangeet. When I'm in Calcutta, that's the most important thing that you hear. We've only had one person who says, I'm more into devotional kind of music rather than Rabindra Sangeet. And you will sing for us, right? Right, wonderful. So you're going to be using the fenugreek as a fodon. Okay. So when you made the mustard paste, you made the paste yourself, or this is something you bought off the shelf?
No, this I made in mixer.
Okay. How much did you take?
4 teaspoon mustard.
Of mustard seeds.
Mustard seeds. 1 green chili.
Okay.
A pinch of salt.
Okay.
And some water.
Water, no oil.
No.
Okay. So you're not using any kind of onion, so the tanginess will come from the raw mango.
Raw mango. Sweet and sour taste.
Okay. And while shallow frying it, did you put any salt, any turmeric?
Turmeric.
So it has been basted with a little bit of turmeric and a little bit of salt and shallow fried. It's not been deep fried, as you can see. The color is still yellow. It's very light, and if I take it and try and press it, you'll see that it is very soft.
Now I'm eating raw mango.
Okay. How many mangoes were there?
Half
a mango paste. And we'll use the entire paste here?
It depends on the taste.
So we have taken about five pieces. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of fish.
I think 6.
Six, okay.
We'll add 1 green chili.
1 green chili. Just a dash of turmeric. Okay. And the mustard paste. So we'll add up the entire mustard paste into it. I'll add water. Enough?
Okay.
Salt. Again, just a little bit more than a pinch. And sugar. Mustard, sugar, all the ingredients that make a Bengali food Bengali is being added now here. Fish, mustard, and sweet. So it will be a sweet, tangy, and the mustard will give the spice kick, right?
Yes.
And we are cooking it on high heat or low heat?
Now it will boil.
Okay.
So it is in high heat.
Okay.
I'll put the fish and then low at the.
A lot of oil, huh? Fish oil, tasty. Tasty and very healthy. So all your PUFA requirements will be fulfilled by that. Your omega unsaturated acids, so good for your heart. That's why Bangs are supposed to have a big heart, they eat a lot of fish, which keeps their heart so healthy. I don't know whether it's so good because a lot of oil is used, which makes it a little bit greasy. But I'm told they have got big hearts, me included. So we're turning it around now.
Yes.
One time, one flip.
I'm going to put some green chilies for the flavor.
The first was the fodor, and now this is for the flavor.
I think it is done.
It's already done?
Already done.
Okay. So we'll cover this up. And we'll put it on low heat. So while we wait for this to take up the steam, why don't we hear something from you?
So now it is spring.
Yes.
So I will sing a Boshonto.
Boshonto eshe geche.
Boshonto porjay Rabindranath.
Okay.
Nil digante ওই ফুলের আগুন লাগলো লাগলো নীল দিগন্তে বসন্তে সৌরভের শিখা জাগলো নীল দিগন্তে ওই ফুলের আগুন লাগলো লাগলো নীল দিগন্তে
Wow, wow. The blue horizon is all set ablaze by the colors of the flowers. It's only Rabindranath who can come up with something, some poetry as beautiful as that. Just imagine, the blue horizon itself is such a beautiful thing, and that is being set ablaze by the colors of the spring flowers, isn't it? That's what Rabindranath says.
That it's done?
It's done. Yeah, I can feel when I, it's even when the lid is being opened up, I can feel when the steam is coming out, the smell of the mustard coming. The gravy should be this consistency, or it should be a little bit more, but not thicker.
It can be, if we take it with the rice,
okay.
then I can keep this
okay.
consistency.
Or we could, if I make it a little bit more consistency.
Best.
When we with rice and then this is the consistency that we require, or else if you want to make it a little bit more thicker, you can make it a little bit more thicker, and that will in fact will be tickling your taste buds that much more, because the flavors will be that much more concentrated. So we'll turn it off now. We'll turn it off now. Wonderful. And let's put it down into this one. Set it aside. And put it here. Wonderful. Wonderful. So you can see, it's not something that is very difficult to make or very time consuming. It's all essentially getting the right ingredients in place. Just shallow fry the fish, and basically you have got something which is ready in about 20-25 minutes flat. All you need to do is basically learn how to buy the fish. That's the critical part of it, getting the right fish, isn't it?
Yes.
Once fresh. You bought the right fresh fish, everything falls in place.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So let me do a little bit of tasting. I'll take a little bit of the gravy from the sides. So you've got this. Now first, Rahanina Dhanam Bhajanam. So let's first start with the smell and let's see what happens. When I try to take this taste, what I'm getting is, I'm getting a very faint smell of the fenugreek. The next smell that comes out to me is that of the mustard. That of the mustard. I've just taken a dash of the gravy to just taste the gravy, and I've got a chakkara wala taste coming out. It's sweet, it's tangy, it's very tangy because of the raw mangoes, and it's got a full bloodied kick of the mustard. And in that is swirling the taste of the fish from the fish oil. Wonderful. So let me dig into the fish now. The fish is lightly cooked, just tenderly cooked, and into it has moved into the flavors. I feel tanginess, I feel sweetness, and I feel the kick of the mustard. The spice of the mustard is excellent. I think one of the key elements is making the mustard paste, isn't
mustard
it?
Paste.
If the mustard paste turns out well, the whole dish will turn out well. And if the mustard paste is not well, it will turn make it bitter.
Bitter taste.
Right, wonderful. This is wonderfully made. I can't have enough of this. Fish bone. Wonderful. So just for everybody to recap, what we did is we took fish. We basted it with a sprinkling of turmeric and salt, and shallow fried it, not deep fried.
No.
Set it aside. Then on the oil we added fenugreek, a whole fenugreek as furon.
One green chili.
And then one green chili as a furon.
Mm.
Then on that we added the mustard paste.
The green
mango paste. That was for the six fish. We took about half a green mango and made paste out of it. Nothing added into it, right? And then we added this into the oil, fried it a little bit, sauteed it, and then added the mustard paste. On that we added just a dash of the turmeric, and just a dash of salt.
Salt.
Right? And a pinch of sugar. No red chili powder is added.
No red chili
powder is added. Now, once that was ready, we added some water in it to increase the quantity so that when we let it simmer, the consistency comes out. And then we added the fish. We added the fish, let it simmer in that sauce for a little bit of time, and then turned it over. And after that, we covered it up for about a minute, 2 minutes time.
2 minutes.
That's all. And we are ready.
Then
and
there's we'll put some
green chilies for the flavor. For the flavor. Wonderful. Such a quick and such a wonderfully tasty thing. I am told that the East Bengali people of the side have made mustard their own, as just as the West Bengalis make posto more their own. Of course, they both make from both sides. But that's one. Are you from East Bengal, by the way? You're from East Bengal, so this is a traditional dish for you and your family, right? Wonderful. So, I mean, that's a very quick and easy way to make a very tasty food for you. Even for bachelors who are wanting to spend a little bit of time alone. So that's a wonderful thing. So if you like what we have done, just go down below to our details, like, spread the joy, share, and subscribe, of course. And till we meet again, happy Holi to you and all of your near and dear ones again. May the colors of joy that were spread on Holi mix in your life for the days to come until next Holi, and of course beyond that also. May white, may red, may green, blue, and all of these colors make life that much more colorful. Till we meet again, thank you Chompari for this wonderful, and for that wonderful song of course also. Thank you for gracing my kitchen.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.